first off, besides this, your charity work has been well chronicled in HBO 24/7. Mm-hmm. What's it mean for you to be down here tonight?
I think it's obviously it's something that as soon as I got home, I heard about this game, and it's something that I jumped at on. I'm pretty big with charity. I got my own charity at home in Toronto, Wayne's Road Hockey Warriors, and I did quite a bit of stuff in Philadelphia as well. And I just think anytime there's a chance for charity, I think it's something you jump at. It's I think us as athletes, we have a big influence on things, and for us to get involved, all the guys, like there's a ton of guys that came down for this, and obviously it's for Hurricane Sandy, and it's. We're gonna raise a lot of money, and it's just gonna be, we're doing the right thing. So,
when you say athletes as a whole, I mean the hockey community. And maybe it's because I cover other sports and you guys so much. Hockey community is a little different than all these guys. I mean, you guys are there every single time.
Yeah.
There's something, and you take a look at this event, right? It's the Devils. Predominantly Devils, yeah. Rangers, and Flyers. You couldn't have three more bitter rivals, yet you guys come together to do this. Off the ice, what's it like to see these other guys?
You know what, whether you believe it or not, the majority of the guys off the ice, we are friends, we've grown up together, we've played against a lot of these guys through our whole years, and obviously when you step on the ice, it's a battle, but when you get off the ice, it's something we can relate to, I think as a hockey player, you're kind of raised in a community where, you're supposed to help out, and you do good things for the people that have done good things for you, and obviously, a lot of these people have been, they've suffered from Hurricane Sandy, and it's, it's the fans, it's our fans, and, you got to treat people right, and it's just, I think this is a huge thing for us, we're going to, like I said, we're going to raise a lot of money, we're going to help out the community, and, we're going to give back.
And also the fact that there'll be 10,000 people here tonight,
yeah.
A little bit of a diversion, but a lot of these first responders work 24/7 around the clock for weeks at a time right afterwards. As much as it's a diversion for them, how much will it be a diversion for you to finally get on the ice in almost like a meaningful game? I know you're training,
yeah.
But it's a little different when it's a game condition than you're shooting against Henrik.
Yeah, it's obviously we're playing against Hank and Brodeur, two of the greatest goalies that ever lived. And I was actually in Europe for 2 months, and it's it doesn't get any better than this. There's a bunch of guys that came out, like I said, to support, and I'm looking forward to it. I think I might even get chills tonight. A lot of Philly fans, and obviously the Philly fans are crazy. A lot of New Jersey fans. We got everyone. Like you said, it's New York, Philly, and Jersey. So it's going to be a great time.
It's interesting to note, Philadelphia, they're not in the same league.
Yeah.
But Toronto State. So kind of psyched with all the moves they made?
Yeah. I got home probably last week, and I heard about everything, and I was pretty excited. I think it takes a lot to compete with the Yankees and the Red Sox, and obviously Baltimore came on last year at Tampa, and I think that's probably the best division in baseball. So, you're gonna have to make moves, and Toronto made moves, and I'm pretty happy about that. I'm a huge Blue Jays fan.
Growing up, who was your favorite player?
Joe Carter, just because my grandma, she was a huge Joe Carter fan, and I remember I used to sit there and watch games with her, and that was her guy. So,
how old were you during the walk-off? Home run.
Born in 88, so I was 4 or 5.
Yeah. Right. I appreciate it.
No problem. My pleasure. Thank you.